share, thank you for watching this final week of 2014. This is it. You're closing out the year and you're getting ready to start the greatest year you've ever had in your life. And you know, this whole month, I've been teaching on steps you can apply in your life that will accelerate your progress. I'm convinced there are things you can do that could take you from a 20-year lifelong goal to achieve that could happen in 3 years. It could happen in 5 years. You could cut the time that it's going to take in the natural for you to achieve this dream if you apply certain steps. So, you know, we're talking about acceleration, speeding up the process. And one of them is you must develop confidence. If you're going to achieve the dreams, the goals God's put in your heart, your confidence is going to have to match your dream level. And, you know, every time God gives you a new dream, He gives you a new goal, you got to develop a whole new level of confidence to go after it. Why? Because God never wants us to just get comfortable, get relaxed, get lazy. We have to keep building ourselves up, building our faith to achieve our dreams. So your confidence has to match your dream level. You know, I heard a story recently about this mayor of a city who was on a float, you know, going down the parade, and he and his wife are waving to the crowd, you know, and all of a sudden he looks out in the crowd and he saw his wife's ex-boyfriend from a long time ago who now own the local gas station. So he's waving and he kind of snickers to his wife and he said, "Aren't you glad you didn't marry him? You could be married to the, you could be working at the local gas station." She just snickered right back and said, "If I'd married him, he'd be the mayor." I love that. She was so confident in who she was. Well, you have to develop your confidence to go after your dreams. You know, Jim Rohn was talking about how years ago, he was actually mentoring Tony Robbins, you know, the motivational coach guru. And he told him, he said, "Tony, you have a poor mentality." He said, "You grew up poor. You have this poor psychology, this poor mentality." He said, "You've got to change the whole way you see yourself, your whole psychology of yourself. You've got to change it if you're going to be successful." He said, you know, the Bible says, "Ask and you shall receive." It also says, "Come boldly to the throne and ask for what you need." And then he told him, he said, "Tony, life will pay you any price you ask of it." So he said, "What I want you to do is go get three $100 bills out of your account." He said, "If that's all you've got in your savings, take it out. Or if you've got that much in your checking, take out three $100 bills." Then he said, "I want you to fold them on the outside of your money clip. If all you have is $5 on the inside, that's fine. But I want you to wrap those $100 bills on the outside of your money clip." And he said, "That way, every time you pull out your money clip, you see wealth, you see abundance, you see success." He said, "This is going to condition yourself to build your confidence to succeed by seeing wealth." So Tony began practicing that. And obviously, he changed his whole psychology and became very successful. Well, years later, Tony was coming out of a motivational conference. He was in Boston, downtown, in the town square. And all of a sudden, this homeless man began to approach him. He saw him coming towards him, and all of a sudden the man said, "Mister, can you loan me a quarter?" Tony thought for a minute, and he said, "I'm going to practice this on this gentleman." He said to him, he said, "Sir, life will pay you any price you ask of it." He said, "Ask and you shall receive. Come boldly and ask." The man, and he held up, he took out his money clip, and he held up the hundreds, he held up the quarter, and he said, "Life will pay you any price you ask of it." He said the homeless man looked at him, looked at the hundreds, looked at the quarter, looked at him, looked at the hundreds, looked at the quarter, and then he said, "You're weird." And he grabbed the quarter and ran off. Now think about this. That man asked for what he thought he was worth. This is what he thought he was worth. And you know, you might snicker and be surprised at that, but what are you asking for? Are you asking God to fill up your car with gas? Or are you asking to pay cash for the car? Life will pay you any price you ask of it. Ask and you shall receive. Come boldly to the throne and ask. You know, I love what Joyce Meyer says. She says, "I'd rather ask for everything and get 50% than ask for nothing and get 100%. What are you asking for in 2015? I want you to build your confidence and your ability to come boldly to the throne and ask for what you want. The other thing is courage. You have got to develop your courage to go after your dreams. You know, you can't stay in the safe zone and expect to live your purpose, live your dreams, fulfill your destiny. You have to build your courage to such a degree that you literally put yourself in uncomfortable situations, in uncomfortable settings. You know those kind of settings that just make you cringe a little bit because you feel so out of place? In fact, you need to get around people who make more money than you, who know more than you, who have more than you, who are smarter than you. The type where you're sitting at the table and you think, I don't even know what to talk about because I'm so out of my league. That's a great place to be. A lot of times I ask myself, Terry, does it make you uncomfortable? The answer is yes, then I commit to doing it. Why? Because it means you're growing. It means that you're building your courage. And every time you conquer that, it gets a little bit easier. Then you move on to the next thing. In fact, that's one of the things that I think is so vitally important about the next conference that we're getting ready to host, January 2015, is when you on purpose step out of that place of comfort. Maybe you've never been to a success conference. Maybe you've never made an investment in yourself and actually put some money on the line and said, I'm doing something different in 2015. I'm going to invest in myself by paying to go to this conference, and I'm going to sit for 2 days and learn how to set goals for my life. I'm going to learn how to have the best year I've ever had in my life. I'm going to sit around with people I don't know, some of them who are millionaires, some of them who are just fresh out of college. I'm going to sit there with people I don't even know, even though it makes me a little uncomfortable. But you know what? It means I'm growing. It means you're growing. That's what you have to do. You know, if success were easy, then everybody would be successful. And if it was all about comfort, trust me, I'd be at home in my ponytail and my jogging suit, just sitting on my bed, sitting on the couch. But you know, you have to build your courage. You have to step out of your comfort zone and do something different. So I want you to get this entire teaching. But for now, I want you to work on developing your confidence and your courage by doing something you normally wouldn't do. And I want to invite you to take advantage of this limited seating. There's limited places available for the next conference. Go online to the website, terry.com/next, and enroll, register for this conference. And I'm telling you, you're going to go home with tools that are going to prepare you to have the greatest year you've ever had. You know, I just met with my team as we close out 2014. We're looking at the goals we set for this year, and we're all just amazed how amazing it is that the goals were achieved. You look at them and some of them are just right on the penny, or we're just $3 off, or it is amazing when you get clear on what you want to achieve. When the vision's clear, the results will appear. So I'm going to challenge you to sign up for the next conference. You won't regret it. And if you're enjoying these podcasts, subscribe to this channel. Follow us on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter. I want to keep you motivated to go after your dreams. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next week.